Okay, so for today we'll start with TCP three-way handshake process. This was actually presented by me. Okay.
Okay.
Then we'll see how it does. So basic, this is how the points what we are going to cover. Introduction to TCP/IP.
Okay.
This TCP/IP is a complete suite of protocols. There are hundreds of the suite, S-U-I-T-E, suite.
S-U-I-T.
S-U-I-T-E. Suite is a pack. It's a kind of pack. It's a pack of protocols.
Okay.
It's a package of multiple protocols.
Okay.
Okay. TCP/IP is a suite of protocols where you have hundreds of protocols at each layer.
Okay.
Like your OSI model. I hope you know OSI model, right?
Yeah.
OSI networking model, which has seven layers.
Yeah.
Starting from physical layer till the application
physical
layer.
Physical network, all that, yeah.
Yeah. Physical data link.
Network data layer. Link,
network layer, transport layer, sessions layer. Presentation layer and application layer.
Yeah.
These are the seven layers of OSI model.
Yeah.
So OSI model is a very basic and very generic model. So taking out of that, taking few leaves out of that, what TCP/IP they have implemented is only five layers.
Okay.
Two, three layers they have grouped together and they have made only five layers.
Okay.
Or some say four layers only.
Okay.
Physical, data link layer, network layer and transport layer.
Okay.
And application layer.
Okay.
So five layers. They have removed sessions and presentation layer.
Okay. In TCP/IP.
Yeah, in TCP/IP. So it's a five layer protocol suite. Okay. Then we see what are the features of TCP/IP. We see what are the merits and demerits of TCP/IP. The pros and cons of TCP/IP. Then we get into connection establishment and termination.
Okay.
How a TCP connection is established and how it is terminated.
Okay.
Okay. What are all the things you have to set? So before understanding this, you need to look into how does a TCP packet looks like? What fields it has? All that it comes here.
Okay. So before doing three-way handshaking, all this we need to know to understand three-way handshake process.
Yes.
Okay.
You should know all this technically, internally, not just the theory-wise. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, sir. Okay.
So all that we'll cover today.
Okay.
Then for tomorrow's class, you will understand once we actually look into Wireshark packet capture files, you will understand what is a SYN, what is ACK, what is SYN+ACK, all these things.
Huh.
Okay.
Yeah.
So these five we'll get into.
So
let me move on to the next slide. Okay. Yeah. Introduction to TCP/IP.
Okay.
So TCP stands for Transmission Control Protocol. It's at layer 4.
Okay.
Okay, which is a transport layer of the TCP/IP suite. Okay, so the transmission control protocol is one of the main protocols of the internet protocol suite. This is the suite I'm talking about.
Pack.
Yeah, it's a pack.
Okay.
Okay, so it originated in the initial network implementation in which it complemented the IP.
Okay.
Okay, so basically TCP and IP both go together. TCP is at layer 4, IP is at layer 3.
Uh-huh.
Internet protocol is at layer 3.
Okay.
IP, the IP address what you talk about.
Okay.
Okay. IP address to connect to any computer, you require an IP address.
Yeah.
So to send some data, you require TCP as well.
Okay.
So both together are called as TCP/IP.
Okay.
But there are multiple other protocols as well, which like ICMP, IGMP. There are so many protocols.
Okay.
Not one, two.
Yeah.
To understand how many protocols are there in TCP/IP suite, let me just get into wiki page of TCP/IP. Okay.
Okay.
TCP/IP. If you say Wikipedia, it mentions all the internet protocol suite. If you open this page, I'll show you how many protocols TCP/IP has. Yeah. Sorry. Get back. Yeah. Look at this. At link layer, these are all the protocols. ARP is one, address resolution protocol, network discovery protocol, open shortest path first protocol. Okay. L2TP tunnels. PPP is a protocol. MAC is a protocol. Wi-Fi is a protocol. DSL is a protocol. All these at this layer.
Yeah.
If you move on to internet layer, which is layer 3. You have IP. Under IP, you have IP version 4, version 6.
Mm.
You have ICMP, Internet Control Messaging Protocol.
Yes.
You have ICMP version 6 for IP version 6.
Yeah.
You have ECN, you have IGMP, you have IPsec. This is for security.
Okay.
You have furthermore.
Okay.
When you move on to transport layer, you have TCP, Transmission Control Protocol.
Okay.
User Datagram Protocol.
Okay.
UDP, DCCP, okay. SCTP. Okay. SCTP uses a four-way handshake. TCP uses a three-way handshake.
Three-way handshake, okay.
SCTP is an advanced version of TCP, which uses a four-way handshake.
Okay.
Okay, just to remember.
Mm.
Okay, these are all the protocols which I deal with day-to-day. Okay. So, RSVP, and there are multiple other protocols. And at application layer, if you see, hell number of protocols you have.
Uh-huh.
So, this entire set of protocols are called TCP-IP suite.
Okay.
Under this, we are just studying now TCP, that's all.
Okay.
You got some idea, right? Now, what is a TCP-IP suite?
Yes, sir.
Each protocol has specific requirement in the network.
Yeah.
Okay. So, we just look into TCP now, Transmission Control Protocol, and how it does, how it works. Okay. So, yeah. Therefore, the entire suite is commonly referred to as TCP-IP.
Okay.
So, all that protocols, whatever I've shown just now, are in a simple term, simple name mentioned as TCP-IP.
Okay.
It's a package.
Okay.
Fine. So, TCP provides reliable, ordered, and error check delivery.
Okay.
It's a reliable protocol. TCP is a reliable protocol, whereas UDP is not a reliable protocol. UDP is unreliable.
Yeah.
Okay. Why TCP is reliable? TCP uses sync numbers. SYN. Whatever you see here, each packet is identified with a sync number.
Okay.
It numbers a number for every packet. And that packet, if it is missed, server comes back and says, I have missed this packet. It's like me sending a cover to you.
Cover?
Yeah, a packet.
Okay.
A courier cover.
Okay.
Post cover sending to you. Okay. And on the top of that, I mention courier number 1.
Okay.
I mail it to you. I post it to you. So after a few days, you receive my courier number 1. And you know that courier number 1 you have received.
Okay.
So in the reply, what you sent to me, you say courier number 1 received.
Okay.
Then you say,
you put a number on the courier sheet. That's it.
Yes, you put a number on the courier sheet. That is what is sync number.
Uh-huh.
So suppose I have sent you 10 courier letters.
Each will have
number. Incremented numbers. 1 to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
So you get to know which is sent and which is not sent. That's why it's unreliable.
Yes. So, suppose for example, you didn't receive 8. Afterwards, you have received 9 and 10.
Okay.
So if I have sent 9 and 10, you will understand that I would have already sent 8. But it is missing. So after a few days, what you will say? I have not received 8 till now. I have waited for 1 week. I have not received it. So please resend. So I will write the same copy mentioning courier number 8 and I will send it to you. Until you receive courier number 8, I will keep on sending it to you. That is how TCP is reliable. Similar way, client and server will number the packets. And then if server does not receive any sequence number in between, it will reply back to the client saying that I have not received these number of packets. I have not received 4, packet number 4. I have not received packet number 8. Please resend. So, client will resend back. Until server receives and acknowledges back saying that I have received packet number 4. I have received packet number 8. That way, they are reliable. So, if you know the internal understandings of how TCP works, you can understand what is reliable and what is ordered. Ordered is order numbers, packet numbers. Then there is error checking as well. Let's not get into how this does the error checking. You just understand that these three points are very valid here. So TCP provides reliable, ordered, and error check delivery of streams.
Okay.
Between applications running and host communicating by an IP network.
Huh.
Okay. So TCP IP is the language of a computer uses to access the internet.
Mm.
Yeah, this we know. It's basically for communicating between two computers on the network.
Yes, sir.
Or on the internet, not network. Yeah, network is basically the internet, not the LAN network.
Uh-huh.
Okay, it's a global internet.
Yes.
It consists of a suite of protocols designed to establish a network of networks to provide a host with access to the internet. Yeah, this is simple terms. It's a suite of protocols which is designed to achieve some tasks.
Uh-huh.
Okay, TCP IP is responsible for full-fledged data connectivity.
Okay. Yeah,
it's basically used for connectivity and transmitting the data end-to-end. Okay, by providing other functions including addressing, mapping and acknowledgement. Uh-huh. ACK is for acknowledgement. This ACK is acknowledgement, short of acknowledgement.
Yes, sir.
SYN is sync numbers, synchronization numbers.
Okay.
Okay.
Acknowledgement mainly saying that if I have got the packet or not.
Yes, that particular packet number you have got or not.
Uh-huh.
Okay, that is acknowledgement.
Okay.
Because it uses this SYN and acknowledgement, it is called reliable.
Yes.
Okay. So TCP IP contains four layers. See, as I said, it is four or five layers. Some say four layers, some say five layers.
Mm.
Okay, which differs slightly from the OSI model.
Yes.
Yeah. So how does it look? What are the four layers? See, again, he has mentioned five layers here.
Yeah.
Here he says four layers. So they are both interchangeably used. Don't get confused with that. If you want, you can rename this. Once I send this slide back to you while practicing, you can put five here.
Okay.
Okay, nothing to worry. See, these are the five layers. Physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, and application layer.
Yes.
No sessions and presentation. They have removed both of them. Removed in the sense they have merged, not removed fully. Those features are there.
Okay.
They have merged it, that's all. They have merged few into transport layer. They have merged few into application layer.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And yeah, these are all the protocols. At network layer, you have very few important protocols called IGMP, ICMP, IP and ARP.
Uh-huh.
Okay. And at transport layer, you have UDP, TCP and SCTP. This is where your TCP sits.
Yes. Okay.
At layer number four.
Uh-huh.
Okay, that is what
in transport layer.
Yeah, in transport layer. Transport layer is layer number four. Either in OSI or in TCP IP model, it's at layer four.
Okay.
Okay. So this is what this picture talks about. So all this, whatever I'm trying to explain to you, same things you have to explain while explaining to the class or your teacher. Okay.
Okay.
This, if you want, you can skip descriptions of different TCP IP protocols.
Okay.
At layer one, what it does, at layer two, what it does. Directly, you can jump into layer four.
There's three,
Yeah, this is actually layer four. Okay. TCP is at layer four, right? Transport layer is layer four. Okay. What this guy does, layer one, he doesn't take physical layer. See, layer three is internet layer, IP layer.
Yes.
Before that is DLL, data link layer. And below that is your physical layer.
Yes.
See, below data link layer is physical layer.
Yeah.
Physical layer, what they do, this both together, they say layer one.
Yes.
This they say layer two. This they say layer three. But to avoid confusion, we say this is layer one, layer two, layer three, layer four.
Okay.
Because layer three is network layer. Layer four is transport layer. Everywhere, wherever you look. Okay. So directly you jump to transport layer.
Okay.
And you start explaining these points. What are the important functionalities of a transport layer where TCP sits? What are the functionalities? It decides if data transmission should be on parallel path or single path.
Okay.
Okay. The functions such as multiplexing, segmenting, splitting on data is done by transport layer. All these functionalities. The applications can read and write the transport layer.
Okay.
The applications which are sitting on the application layer. Here, all your applications can be able to write and read from the transport layer.
Okay.
That's what he's trying to mention here.
Okay.
Okay. The transport layer adds header information to the data.
Okay.
You know how OSI model works, right? From the application layer, every packet is sent below.
Yes, yes, yes.
Until the physical layer. Yeah. So at every layer, what happens? It adds its own header files. You read that, right?
Yes, yes, yes.
It keeps on adding its own header files.
Yes.
Application layer adds its own header file. Then
In transport layer, sir.
Everywhere. Uh-huh. Every layer adds it. Every layer adds its own header file. Okay. Like that, similarly, transport layer also adds transport header information.
Okay.
To the data. Data is the actual data to be sent from computer host A to host B.
Yes.
Okay. Or from client to server.
Mm.
So, transport layer breaks the message into small units so okay. that they're handled more efficiently by the network layer.
Okay.
Okay. Below layer. Transport layer is above network layer. So, transport layer breaks the message data into small units so that network layer will be able to easily handle it, easily and efficiently handle it.
Yes.
These are all the functionalities in brief.
Yes.
Not in the technical terms, very technical terms, but for the layman. Don't get into all the technicalities of this.
Okay.
Because our main topic is to demonstrate how a connection is established and how a connection is terminated.
Header information is mainly where the next, the data has to go. No, sir?
No, header consists of a lot of things.
Okay.
Okay, we'll see that. Once we see the packet header file, there are a lot of fields inside that.
Okay.
I'll show you the further slides, you will get that.
Okay.
Okay. Once we have that picture on the screen, we can talk about that.
Okay.
Let me, okay, full screen this so that it's easy to understand. Yeah. So transport layer, this we have seen. Transport layer also arranges the packets to be sent in sequence.
Okay.
Yeah, this is the layer. TCP is the main person to mark the packets with numbers so that they can be identified in sequence.
Okay.
Okay, that is where is the sync number comes in.
Okay.
We'll see. And the application, these are the functionalities of application layer. If you have time, you can go through these as well.
Okay.
But for us, it is TCP now.
Okay.
So let's not get into all the other layers.
Okay.
Okay. Then this points we see TCP, Transmission Control Protocol. It is a reliable connection-oriented protocol which handles byte streams from source to destination without error and flow control.
Okay.
Okay. Then UDP is exact opposite of that. It's an unreliable connectionless protocol. This is connection oriented protocol. This is a connectionless protocol.
Okay.
What is a connection? How is it called a connection oriented protocol? Because of three way handshake.
Okay.
That is why it's called connection oriented.
Okay.
Once three-way handshaking connection is established, only then client will be able to send data to the server.
And it will be more reliable also because it's connection-oriented.
Yes, yes. Because it is connection-oriented and because the packets are numbered sequentially, it is reliable.
Usually through a cable, so there won't be noise and data loss.
Yes, exactly. So, yeah. Now we'll move on to the next topic called merits and demerits of TCP/IP. Okay, so merits, what are the advantages? Merits are advantages, demerits are disadvantages. Are pros and cons.
Okay.
So what are the pros? It can be operated independently.
Okay.
It's not dependent on any other protocols.
Okay.
Okay. It is scalable.
Okay.
Scalable in the sense, as long as you have large number of connections, it can scale up to that.
Okay.
Same TCP can work for any number of connections.
Okay.
Okay, so it is a client server architecture basically. Okay.
Okay.
Then it supports a number of routing protocols.
Okay.
Okay, routing protocols are in the sense IP protocols.
Okay.
Like IPv4, IPv6, ICMP, there are so many protocols. Okay, hundreds of protocols you have routing protocols. So all that it supports. And TCP can be used to establish a connection between two computers.
Okay.
Okay. Then what are the demerits? The transport layer does not guarantee delivery of packets. Okay. The model cannot be used in any other application. Okay, let's not worry about this. Only the advantages are more important. Okay, he says replacing protocol is not easy. I think there is not any need for replacing TCP as of now.
Yes.
It will be there for so many generations to come. Okay, so let's not worry about the demerits. It has not clearly separated its services, interfaces and protocols. Okay. There are few demerits. You just read them out. Okay. Nobody will ask you what is this, what is this and all. Because our main concentration is connection establishment and connection termination.
Yeah.
Once we get into that, you have a lot of technical things inside again.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Now we are moving into connection establishment.
Okay.
So what is a connection basically? Connection is a virtual path between the source and destination. Source in the sense a client, destination in the sense a server.
Server.
Or host A and host B. Whatever. Okay. So how is a TCP connection oriented while using IP? Okay. See, IP is a connectionless.
Okay.
There comes a question saying that how is the TCP a connection oriented protocol?
And it's using a connectionless protocol.
Yeah. Using connectionless because TCP first it has to have an IP.
Yeah.
TCP works on top of IP.
Okay.
Okay. That's why it is written.
But IP TCP is connectionless.
That's why it is written TCP on top of IP. TCP slash IP is TCP on top of IP.
Okay.
Like if they give you marks, they say 25 on top of 30 slash 30 they write, right?
20, yeah, yeah.
25 slash 30 is 25 on top of 30.
Yes, sir.
25 on 30 you have got. So like that, TCP works on top of IP always.
Okay.
Without IP, TCP will never work.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So how is it called connection oriented? Because?
Connection.
Yeah, because the connection is virtual. TCP meaning? Is a server. Connection is virtual in the sense you will not have any physical connection.
Virtual. Then that will become a connectionless, no, sir?
See, now we both are connected. You are able to see my screen, right?
Yes.
So how are we both connected? Can you show me the exact wire which is a connection between your computer and my computer? Sir.
No.
Is it possible? No.
No.
That's a virtual connection.
Okay.
But still there is a connection between you and me. Only you are able to see my screen. Nobody else in the internet.
Yeah.
So that's a connection-oriented thing, and that's a connection is virtual.
Yeah.
Okay. So that way, there is a lot of data going on between your computer and my computer. See, if I'm sharing my entire screen, there are a lot of packets moving from my computer to your computer. Okay. In a virtual connection.
Okay.
TCP uses the services of IP to deliver. That's what we've spoken about. IP is unaware of retransmission out of order segments. So IP does not know anything. That is why it's called connectionless. But TCP knows what is ordering, what is the sequence of packets, and what are the acknowledgements, how many packets are received by the server. So all that it maintains.
Okay.
That's why it's called connection oriented.
Okay.
Then this is how your basic connection looks like at a very top level.
Okay.
This is a client, this is a server, and this is the timeline. Okay. So client at this point has sent a sync request. Then server receives sync.
Okay. And receive acknowledgement that it has received sync.
And it adds acknowledgement to this SYN packet. This each one is a packet. SYN is a packet. SYN packet is being sent by client to the server.
Okay.
So server receives that. And within this SYN packet, it will have client's IP address and client port number as well. Okay. Then server receives that, replies back with an ACK, SYN+ ACK packet.
Okay.
This is a SYN+ ACK packet. It replies back to the client. Now client receives that. Okay, and then it opens and reads it and says, okay, this is the acknowledgement packet what I have received from server.
Yes.
That means server is willing to establish a connection with me.
Yes, yes.
And then it removes SYN and then sends back acknowledgement. Only ACK packet.
Okay.
ACK packet by incrementing the ACK number. How these numbers are incremented, what exactly, what fields are incremented, All these we will see technically.
So
in a general bird's eye view, this is what happens in the three-way handshake connection. This is a connection establishment.
Yes.
Once server receives an ACK, then the three-way handshake procedure is successful.
Yes.
Now client can send any amount of data it wants to send to the server.
Yes.
So after sending the data, it has to again do a three-way handshaking for connection termination.
Yeah.
If it wants to terminate a connection with the server, it has to similar way do the termination connection termination procedure.
After it has finished its job.
After it has sent all the data which it has to send from client to server or server to client.
Okay, okay.
It has to close the connection.
Close the connection, yeah.
Okay, it can't keep it open.
Yes, yes.
It has to close the connection. Or else server will get overloaded.
Yes.
It can't maintain millions of connections. Okay. So, that is the connection termination thing. Now, as of now, we are looking at connection establishment.
Yeah.
So, for connection establishment, three packets are required. Remember this. First, client send a thin packet. Okay. We'll see all the details, how, what a thin packet looks, what contents it looks. Okay. All that. SYN is a packet.
Yes.
Okay. Then after receiving SYN packet, to the same SYN packet, it adds acknowledgement and sends back to the client.
Okay.
Now, how does server know the details of client, which client it has to send? SYN packet contains that.
Yes.
This packet contains the IP address of client and the port number of client.
Yes.
Okay. Server's port number is already known because server's port number is TCP. TCP is a very well recognized port number, which is 80.
Okay.
Okay. So that is known.
So
it sends back the SYN plus ACK packet. Now after receiving SYN plus ACK packet, client sends back the ACK packet, only ACK packet.
Okay.
To the server.
Okay.
Now once these three steps are done, a three-way handshake connection establishment procedure is successful.
Successful. Okay. Oh, okay.
Okay. So now what you have to do at the server in the lab. In the lab, what is your task at the server? Assuming that your client and server are both the same packets, you have two processes running. One is client process, one is server process.
Okay.
So at the server, you have to capture these packets. SYN packet, SYN plus ACK packet, and ACK packet.
Yes.
On port number 80. So who will capture that for you? The Wireshark tool. The Wireshark tool.
Oh.
Okay. There is a tool called Wireshark.
Okay.
Which you have to install on the server.
Okay.
To capture the packets.
Okay.
That I'll tell you tomorrow. What is Wireshark, how it is done and all. Tomorrow I'll tell you. Okay. So once you install that Wireshark tool. Wireshark is the world's number one packet capture tool. Remember that. It's the world's number one packet capture tool.
Okay.
There are other tools as well which are very old, like TCP dump. TCP dump is a command on Linux and Unix machines. TCP dump is captures the TCP packets on a given port.
Okay.
Okay. But Wireshark is a GUI tool, graphical user interface tool.
Okay.
Okay. So once you capture packets on port number 80 on this machine, you capture these three packets. SYN, SYN+ACK. Three packets for connection establishment you capture.
Sir, ACK ACK is sent back from client to server, right?
Yes.
That is nothing but acknowledging that yes, you have accepted the connection, so even I have accepted it, like that, right?
No. Yeah. ACK is that only. See, from the starting, if you see, now client does not know, now server does not know what a client is. But client knows, I have to communicate with this server.
Yes.
So, openly it sends a request, SYN request.
Okay.
Openly it sends a SYN request. Server's TCP IP address is known.
Okay.
Okay, it's a well-known communicated IP address.
Okay.
Like timesofindia.com. Timesofindia.com, everyone knows in the world.
Yes, sir.
That's a server. Timesofindia.com is a server.
Yes.
That IP address is well known. If you look at DNS, domain name server, what is Times of India's IP address, you will come to know.
Oh, okay.
Okay, and the port.
Okay.
So anybody can send a request. It is up to the server whether to accept it or reject it. See, if I send you a registered post,
okay.
If I send you a speed post, it is up to you whether to accept that letter or not.
Okay.
If you want to accept the letter, you take the letter from the postman.
Okay.
And sign on the register saying that I have received that.
Yes, sir.
If you don't want to accept that, suppose your enemy has sent something, you don't want to take that, then you just say, I don't want to take it. I'll not sign on that. You throw it in the dustbin and go.
Okay.
Okay. So that server can do. If it wants to accept, it can accept. Or if it feels that this client is a stupid fellow, I don't want to accept any packet from him.
Okay.
It just drops it. It does not send any SYN+ACK packet back.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. This is a successful connection what we are looking at.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. So first SYN packet is sent. Now server wants to establish a connection with that client.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Thinking that I have to communicate something to them. Now what it does? It sends back the same SYN packet along with an ACK.
Okay.
Saying that I have received your SYN packet.
Okay.
And this is the acknowledgement for that.
Okay.
Now, once SYN+ACK packet is received by client, client knows that server has received his SYN packet.
Yes, sir.
Now, server has sent an ACK to client with this. Now, client has to send an ACK back to the server saying that it has received its acknowledgement.
Okay.
See, client has received server's acknowledgement in this.
Yes.
And that acknowledgement is sent back through this ACK packet.
Okay.
Now, after receiving this ACK packet by the server,
okay,
server knows that client has received his own ACK packet. And now both have understood that connection has to be established.
Has to be established. Okay. Okay.
Now a connection is successfully established. TCP connection.
Okay.
This is called a three-way handshake.
Understood.
These three are different packets.
Okay. Okay.
Now, by using Wireshark tool, capture a PCAP file and then open the PCAP file in Wireshark, and you have to show all the fields in this SYN+ACK and ACK packets.
Yes.
That is what you have to do in the lab.
Yes, sir.
Not create a client and server. Okay. Don't worry of creating a client and server. You have to just accept. Open the PCAP file and then demonstrate these packets.
Okay.
What these packets contain.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Now, SYN. What is a SYN packet? It is for synchronization of sequence numbers.
Sequence numbers.
SYN is short for synchronization. S-Y-N. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Then it consumes one sequence number. Every SYN packet will have a separate sequence number.
Okay.
SYN packet does not carry any real data.
Huh.
These three packets are just used only for communication, establishment, connection. Real data is sent after this.
Okay. Yes, yes, yes.
Real
after
data,
these three steps, real data is
sent. Yeah, real data is sent after these three steps. Not, these packets will not contain any real data.
Huh.
Okay. So this is in short what is SYN packet.
Yeah.
What it does and what it contains. Then what is SYN+ACK packet? SYN segment for communication in other direction and ACK.
Okay.
Okay, see. SYN on the other direction from server to client.
Okay.
SYN is from client to server. This SYN is from server to client.
Yes.
Plus ACK.
Yes.
Okay. So it consumes one sequence number again.
Yes, sir.
This also will have sequence number. And what is just ACK? Just an ACK segment, acknowledgement segment.
Final acknowledgement.
It does not have any sequence number inside.
Yes.
Okay. So this is in brief. Yeah. This is connection termination. Same thing. Instead of SYN, you will have FIN packet here.
Huh.
FIN is for finish.
Yes.
So if client now, whatever information it has got from the server, after that, it has to close the connection. So client will initiate the FIN connection termination procedure.
Okay.
Now it says, client says, okay, I've got the information what server has to send me. Now I don't have any further work with the server. So I want to close this connection.
Okay.
So it sends a FIN packet. Server receives that and then says, okay, I've received your FIN packet along with the acknowledgement. Now you can close the connection. Then FIN plus ACK after client receives it, it sends an acknowledgement back to the server.
Okay.
Then server terminates the connection.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. After that, there is no any connection. TCP connection. Okay.
Yes.
So same thing. FIN, FIN plus ACK and ACK, what it does.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So all this you have to explain there.
Mm.
Okay. Yeah. This is a three-way handshake processor picture in a picture. See, now this is a TCP server.
Okay.
TCP is exposed on port number 80.
Okay.
This is a very well worldwide known port.
Okay.
It's a standard port. You need not change the number. Okay. TCP port is 80. Now, this is your TCP client, blue one.
Yes. Yes.
Now, through this port, say this is some random port. Random ports are from 1024 to 65,535. It can have any number out of this.
Okay.
That is randomly generated.
Okay.
This is not fixed. But this is fixed. 80 is fixed always.
Okay.
Okay. So what it does, client through this port sends a SYN packet.
Okay.
This is first step.
Okay.
On to port number 80.
Okay.
Now TCP server reads port number 80. This interface it will always be reading.
Okay.
Okay. And now along with this, your Wireshark will also be reading this if you install Wireshark. On this, whatever packets are coming on port number 80, it captures.
Yes, yes.
Wireshark. Now SYN packet it captures.
Yes.
Okay. Then TCP server, what it does, it sends back a SYN ACK.
Okay.
To the same port, same client. Then TCP client sends an ACK packet back to port number 80.
Okay.
So these three packets your Wireshark will capture.
Okay.
And then these three packets you have to open and study. And show it to your ma'am. What are there inside the contents? That I'll tell you tomorrow.
Okay.
So this is what, how technical. Yeah, this simple thing, these three slides we'll see. And we are done for today.
Okay.
These are the steps with some example numbers. Okay. Step one. Step one is sending a SYN packet.
Yes. To server.
This is step one.
Yes.
SYN packet. So what does SYN packet actually contain? See, device A, which is client. Client sends TCP packet, TCP segment with SYN equals to 1.
Yeah.
Comma, ACK equals to 0.
Yes.
Okay. So SYN equals, these are separate fields.
Okay.
Within the TCP header,
okay.
SYN and ACK are the fields.
Okay.
Okay, let me show you that in another slide. Hold on. I suppose I have another slide. Because this takes some time for you to understand.
Okay.
That's why I said it takes few classes, not one. Okay. These are actually very technical things. In this, I don't have. Anyways, the TCP header tomorrow I'll show you. Okay, you will understand it much better. For as of now, or let me just simply hold on. See, TCP header, if you say in Google, yes, this is this. If you get into images, you can see what is a TCP header. Anywhere you can see.
Yes.
Yeah. Open this, for example. I say, open this in a new tab, this image. Yes. See, this entire thing is a TCP header.
Yes.
What is the length of this TCP header? It is 32 bits.
32 bits.
32 bits is 4 bytes. 4 bytes.
Yes.
Okay. Now, if you look at this, each, it has multiple sections in that.
Yeah.
This is port number, source port number. This is destination port number.
Yes.
See, I told you, right, in this thing. This, my God, why it always goes to the first slide. Yeah, here, when TCP client sends a SYN packet, okay, SYN packet is sent inside the header file, TCP header file.
Okay.
Okay, what does TCP header file contains? TCP header file contains all these.
Yes, yes.
You see this SYN packet
sequence
here?
Sequence number.
You see this SYN field here?
Yes.
SYN.
Yes, sir.
See, there are six fields here.
Okay.
Each one is one bit. Each one is one bit, that's all.
Yes.
URG, urgent, ACK field, PSH, I'm not sure what is it. RST, okay. I'm not sure.
Okay.
SYN for synchronous SYN field. And this is for FIN field. SYN is for connection establishment, FIN is for connection termination.
Termination.
ACK is acknowledgement packet.
Okay.
Okay. Along with that, it has source port number, source destination port numbers, all this. You see the sequence number here? This is the sequence number field.
Okay.
Okay. Now we are dealing with this sequence number, SYN field, and ACK fields.
Okay.
Remaining all fields, you need not worry now.
Okay.
This sequence number, this SYN field, and ACK field. Okay. Now, if you look at the slide, yeah, see. At step one, when it is sending a SYN packet,
okay,
in the TCP IP header, in the TCP header,
okay,
it is setting that SYN field to 1.
Yes.
See, it's a 1-bit field. Either you can set 0 or either you can set 1.
Okay.
1 bit means that's all, right? Two values.
Yes.
0 or 1.
Yes.
So SYN field you set to 1.
Okay.
ACK field you set to 0.
Okay.
And the sequence number field you set to some value. This could be random value.
Okay.
Here
it
is 2000.
Okay.
Okay. So now this is a SYN packet. This is sent to the server.
Okay. Okay.
Now what server does? Server receives that TCP segment.
Okay.
And returns a TCP segment, TCP header. Segment is a header.
Okay.
It returns the TCP header with same SYN. SYN equals to 1. Acknowledgement now set to 1.
Okay.
And starting sequence number to 5000. Server is starting at 5000 sequence number. Client is starting at 2000.
Okay.
These are some random numbers.
Okay.
But these you have to concentrate. SYN 1, ACK 0 at step 1.
Yes. Okay.
Step 2, what server does? It says SYN 1, ACK 1.
Yes.
Okay. And acknowledgement number, it increments to 1. See, earlier it was 2000.
Yes.
Now it says 2000 plus 1, which is 2001. This is the ACK number, acknowledgement number itself.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And then this thing it sends back to the client. This is called SYN plus ACK packet.
Yes, sir.
This is SYN plus ACK.
Yes.
Now, client receives that SYN plus ACK. Now, what client does?
Okay.
Now, what client does? It makes SYN, it
send
makes
back
SYN
an
to
ACK.
0.
Okay, and ACK to 1.
ACK remains 1.
Yes.
Sequence number 2001.
Yes, yes. So, starting it will be SYN will be 1, ACK will be 0. Okay, that's why only SYN will be there.
Yes.
Then server will send a SYN 1, ACK 1. That's why SYN plus ACK.
Yes.
And then client will send, SYN won't be there, only an acknowledgement to the server. That's it.
Acknowledgement and along with sequence numbers.
Yes.
You should not forget. Okay. See, same sequence number 2001. And acknowledgement, it was 5,000 here.
Yes.
That is incremented.
Okay.
Okay. So this is what actually what happens inside these values. So these okay. values you have to show in the packets, actual packets, okay. Wireshark captured okay. packets. That if you show and demonstrate, okay, the values that tomorrow I'll show you, the Wireshark okay. capture file, packet capture okay. file, I'll open that and I'll show you how to realize and recognize those values.
Okay, sir.
Okay, that is what is your assignment.
Okay.
To observe, uh-huh. not implement.
Uh-huh.
See, in the brackets, it is not implement.
Okay.
See, if I ask you to read TCP connection, you have to read. You should not write
okay.
it.
Okay.
If they ask just to observe, you have to observe the packets, that's all. You have to observe okay. the TCP three-way handshaking procedure. Locating different packets. What are the packets?
Uh-huh.
SYN, SYN+ACK, ACK.
Okay.
These three are for connection oriented.
Uh-huh.
I mean, for establishment.
Hmm.
Then for connection termination, they are FIN, FINAC and ACK.
This we have to do. Extra we have to do, I guess, even if they're not asked.
Yeah, you have to show this. Both you have to show. Then only you'll get full marks.
Okay. I'll just find out, sir, if that's all we need to do or what. I'll just find out.
Yeah, definitely. You can find out.
Yes.
You need not implement TCP server. That is a very complicated procedure.
Okay.
Okay. So you need not implement TCP server. TCP server is already there. Only thing is that you have to capture packet and then open the packets and demonstrate all these fields.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Inside that.
Yes, sir.
This is for connection termination.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
So this entire procedure is called, this handshaking technique is referred to as three-way handshake or SYN+ACK.
Okay.
So this is how TCP three-way handshake connection establishment works.
Okay, sir.
Now we have only seen connection establishment.
Okay.
Okay. So what we will do tomorrow, we will look at what is Wireshark and we will understand the captured files
okay
and we will differentiate where is a SYN packet, where is SYN+ACK packet, where is ACK packet,
okay,
and we will also identify what are the values for this.
Okay, sir.
Okay, what are the values for this?
Yes.
SYN packet, ACK yes. packet, all this we will see tomorrow.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this same slide you have to present there.
Okay.
Along with this, we have to add a few more things. I will tell you tomorrow what to add to this.
Okay, sir.
We need to put some screenshots of capture file inside.
Uh-huh.
Or you can directly show that as a demonstration.
Okay.
That I'll tell you tomorrow.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
Fine, Chirag, then. So okay, you understood, sir, right? What is TCP IP three-way handshake now?
Yes, sir, I understood.
In detailed.
Yes, sir.
These three steps, what happens is in detailed.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
So step one, what are SYN and ACK values and ISN values?
Okay.
Then step two, what server changes those values to?
Yes.
Along with ACK. And step three, what client sends back to the server?
Sir,
these values you have to remember. These are all the technical values inside.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Same thing you have to show there in the actual packet.
Yes, sir.
That I'll show you tomorrow.
Okay.
Fine, Chirag, then.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye, sir. Good night.